ఇంటర్మీడియట్ విద్యా రంగంలో అగ్రగామి మన ఎన్ఎస్ఆర్ ఇంపల్స్ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ ఇన్స్టిట్యూషన్ ఐఐటి జేఈఈ అయినా నీట్ అయినా తిరుగులేని విద్యా సంస్థ ఎన్ఎస్ఆర్ ఇంపల్స్.
నెక్స్ట్ న్యూక్లియోఫిలిక్ ఎడిషన్ రియాక్షన్ ఈజ్ ఎడిషన్ విత్ సోడియం బై సల్ఫైట్ NaHSO3. Okay, reaction with NaHSO3, sodium bisulfite, NaHSO3, right. Carbonyl compound, this is carbonyl compound. It may be a aldehyde or ketone. Carbonyl compound, aldehyde or ketone. This carbonyl compound reacts with sodium bisulfite, NaHSO3, sodium bisulfite, Na plus H plus here SO3 minus 2. What about carbonyl compound? Nucleophilic addition reaction. This is nucleophile. Nucleophilic addition reaction takes place. It gives carbon with oxygen, here Na, and SO3H group. SO3H. SO3 minus and H plus. After that, what happened? Here proton transfer takes place. Proton transfer takes place. This proton is transferred from sulfur to oxygen. So it gives carbon and here OH group and SO3Na. Okay, this is the adduct formation or product, addition product, sodium bisulfite addition product. It is a crystalline compound. Yes, carbonyl compound on treatment with sodium bisulfite to form a intermediate compound which is in transfer of hydrogen. Proton transfer takes place from sulfur to oxygen. It gives addition product, that is nothing but adduct. Adduct is nothing but addition product. Addition, A-D-D-I-T-I-O-N, addition product is equal to adduct. Addition product is nothing but adduct. Okay, adduct means addition in first three letters. Addition first three letters, product last three letters, ADDUCT. ADDUCT is equal to adduct. Adduct is nothing but addition product. Okay, now your sodium bisulfite addition product is obtained. In this reaction, if it is aldehyde group, this carbonyl group is, here this carbonyl group is aldehyde, first statement. If this carbonyl group is aldehyde, CHO, equilibrium shifts towards right hand side. Okay, here this carbonyl group is particularly aldehyde group. This equilibrium shift towards right hand side, that is nothing but product formation takes place. Here product is obtained, product formation takes place. If this carbonyl group is ketonic group, equilibrium shifts towards left hand side means backward reaction takes place. Backward reaction means here reactant formation takes place. So from this addition product, we are getting the carbonyl compounds by treatment with dilute mineral acid or dilute mineral base. So therefore, here from the addition product, from the addition products, carbonyl compounds are obtained. Carbonyl compounds are obtained by treatment with dilute mineral acid or base. Okay, so regain the carbonyl compound from this reaction. How it is possible? By this Edison product is treated with dilute mineral acid or dilute mineral base. Preferentially, backward reaction takes place, means equilibrium shifted towards left hand side, we are getting the carbonyl compounds. So in this reaction, nucleophilic addition, crystalline compound is obtained. Adduct is nothing but addition product. In this reaction, if carbonyl group is aldehyde group, equilibrium shift towards right hand side, product formation takes place, that is a forward reaction, especially forward reaction. If this carbonyl compound is ketone, equilibrium shift towards left hand side, equilibrium shift towards left hand side means reactant formation, that is nothing but backward reaction is preferably takes place, backward reaction. From this addition product, we can regenerate the carbonyl compound on treatment with dilute mineral acid or base. Okay, this is addition of sodium bisulfite, NaHSO3, sodium bisulfite addition. Next one is reaction with water, H2O, reaction with water. Yes, carbonyl compounds plus water gives rise to carbonyl compound hydrates formation. Carbonyl compounds hydrates formation. Equation R C double bond O H aldehyde. R, this hydrogen is replaced by alkyl group, that is ketone. Aldehyde or ketone. On treatment with water, H2O, H plus OH minus. This OH minus nucleophile is added to the carbonylic carbon, and positive part is attached to the oxygen. Nucleophilic addition reaction. First, nucleophile is initiated by the reaction and followed by electrophile. So, it is nucleophilic addition. In this case, the product is alkyl group, carbon and OH. Here also OH, here it is aldehyde or ketone. So this aldehyde or ketone on treatment with water, formation of hydrates. Hydrates formation takes place. This hydrate is unstable hydrate. It is unstable compound. Why it is unstable? Only one carbon atom possesses two hydroxyl groups. In entire chemistry, if only one carbon atom possesses two hydroxyl groups or more than two hydroxyl groups, unstable. So immediately it is undergoes dehydration reaction. Okay, immediately it undergoes dehydration reaction. So dehydration means removal of water. Removal of water to produce carbonyl compound, aldehyde or ketone. Backward reaction takes place. Okay, this is unstable hydrate. Okay, students, if water is added to the carbonyl compound to produce unstable hydrate, it is not a stable hydrate. If you take any aldehyde or ketone, here unstable hydrate is formed. But how to produce the stable hydrates? Here stable hydrates are produced if the carbonyl group must be possess electron withdrawing groups or electron accepting groups. If electron accepting groups are present, that carbonyl compound produces stable hydrates. Okay, note if the carbonyl compound possess electron withdrawing group or electron accepting groups produces stable hydrates. Okay, if the carbonyl compound possess electron withdrawing group or electron accepting groups, that is produces stable hydrates. So how it is possible? Here electron accepting group like chloral, best example is chloral trichloroacetaldehyde. This is chloral, or another name is trichloroacetaldehyde is called as chloral molecule. It is aldehyde. It contains three electron accepting groups or electron withdrawing groups. Chlorine here also. So what happened here? This carbon electron withdraws from carbonylic carbon. So here on this carbonylic carbon, positive charge increase means nucleophilic addition reaction takes place to form a stable hydrate. So here addition of water, okay, H plus and OH minus gives rise to nucleophilic addition reaction takes place, OH minus nucleophile and here hydrogen. Now the product is, yes, chlorine, carbon, and chlorine. Next, carbon, here OH group. Next, here OH and hydrogen atom. Okay, in this case, here chlorine, hydrogen attached to more electronegative oxygen. In between hydrogen and chlorine, due to the presence of three electron withdrawing groups, here hydrogen bond formation takes place, or chelation. Here also say between chlorine and hydrogen bond formation, or it is also nothing but chelation. So due to chelation, it is the stable hydrate. It is a stable hydrate. This is called as chloral hydrate. Chloral hydrate is the stable hydrate due to chelation. But in generally, without electron withdrawing groups or without electron accepting groups, aldehydes or ketones on treatment with water to produce unstable hydrates. But how to produce the stable hydrates? Here stable hydrates are produced if the carbonyl compound possesses electron withdrawing groups or electron accepting groups. They can produce stable hydrates like chloral. In this chloral molecule, three electron withdrawing groups are there, three electron accepting groups. So due to high electronegativity, here on this carbonyl carbon, positive charge enhances. Therefore, nucleophilic addition reaction takes place to produce stable chloral hydrate due to chelation or hydrogen bonding. Yes, and one more important reaction. And one more reaction. CF3, C double bond O, CF3 on treatment with water. Okay, your compound is X. This X compound is stable or unstable? It is stable compound or unstable compound? Yes, here hexafluoroacetone reacts with water. Carbon, fluorine, fluorine, fluorine. Next, C double bond O, carbon, fluorine, fluorine and fluorine. Hydrolysis means water. What happen? Nucleophilic addition reaction takes place. This carbonyl carbon, 500 electrons shifted towards oxygen, oxygen negative and carbon positive. So nucleophilic addition reaction. Now here electrophilic addition. First the reaction is initiated by nucleophile and followed by electrophile. Now the product is fluorine, carbon, fluorine and fluorine. A carbon with OH group. Next, here also OH group, carbon, fluorine, and also fluorine and fluorine. In this case, what happened here? Between the hydrogen and fluorine, hydrogen bond formation takes place. Here also same, between hydrogen and fluorine, hydrogen bonding. Okay, presence of hydrogen bonding, presence of hydrogen bonding, this is the stable hydrate. Okay, stable hydrate, there is no backward reaction, only forward reaction takes place to form stable hydrate. So therefore, here X compound is the stable hydrate but not a unstable hydrate. Why? Because your electron accepting groups are fluorine, 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 here also fluorine. So all these are electron acceptors. Therefore, it is produced by stable hydrates. Okay? So without electron accepting groups, carbonyl compounds on treatment with water to form a unstable hydrates. They are stabilized by introducing electron accepting groups on the carbonylic compounds, on the carbonyl compounds. Okay, this is nucleophilic addition reaction. And another one is a reaction with ammonia, NH3, a reaction with ammonia, NH3. Yes. Here 6 moles of formaldehyde and treatment with hexamethylene tetraamine. Sorry, ammonia. 6 moles of formaldehyde and treatment with 4 moles of ammonia. Okay? Hexamethylene tetraamine formation. CH2 taken 6. Here hexamethylene. Tetraamine N4 plus here 6 moles of water. Okay, students, 6 moles of formaldehyde. This is very important reaction. It is a formaldehyde molecule. 6 moles of formaldehyde on treatment with 4 moles of ammonia. 6 moles of formaldehyde reacts with 4 moles of ammonia to produce hexamethylene tetraamine. Okay, the name of the compound is hexamethylene tetraamine. Hexamethylene tetraamine, or it is also called as urotrophin. Okay, it is also called as urotrophin, or methanamine. It is also called as methanamine. Okay, methanamine, hexamethylene tetraamine, or urotrophin, or it is also called as methanamine. What is the main importance of hexamethylene tetraamine or urotrophin? Urotrophin, it is used as a anti-infective agent. Hexamethylene tetraamine or urotrophin used as anti-infective agent. Okay, it is used as urotrophin is used as anti-infective agent. Okay, anti-infective agent. Especially it is used in the treatment of urinary infections. It is especially used as treatment of urinary infections. It is used in the treatment of urinary infections, especially urinary infections. Okay, 6 moles formaldehyde reacts with ammonia to produce urotrophin. This urotrophin is used as anti-infective agent, or especially used for urinary infections. Treatment of urinary infections. What is the structure of urotrophin? Okay, urotrophin structure is here nitrogen. Okay, now CH2 group like this. Here CH2 group. Next, CH2 group, in this CH2, next here CH2 group, next CH2 group, methylene group, CH2 methylene group. Yes, this is the urotrophin structure. Okay, one nitrogen. Here nitrogen, tetraamine, hexamethylene, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, this is the structure of urotrophin. Okay, how it is obtained? Formaldehyde on treatment with ammonia to produce erotropin. So what is the main importance of erotropin? Erotropin is the anti-infective agent, especially it is used for the treatment of urinary infections. Okay, in this erotropin, so nitrogen it is participate in sp3 hybridization because of one lone pair of electrons are present, sp3 hybridization. Here carbons are also, methylene groups are also participate in sp3 hybridization. Okay, in erotropin both nitrogen and carbon atom participate in sp3 hybridization. Okay, yes, this is one more nucleophilic addition reaction. And another reaction is either aldehyde or CHO. Aldehyde reacts with ammonia, NH3, where ammonia is the nucleophile, therefore nucleophilic addition reaction takes place. Nucleophilic addition, these pi bonded electrons shifted towards oxygen. Okay students, aldehyde plus ammonia. Ammonia, it is the nucleophile. Okay, neutral nucleophile. Nucleophile is added to the carbonyl carbon. It gives RCO-. Here hydrogen is there and ammonia, NH3 ammonia. Loss of electrons, it gets positive charge. Then next, what? Here nitrogen is the positive charge, so this is less stable, therefore these electrons are shifted towards nitrogen, it releases H plus. So this H plus ion is attached to the oxygen, gives rise to RCOH. Here hydrogen, nitrogen, hydrogen and hydrogen. Okay, further heating, Removal of water, it gives RCH double bond NH. It is called as imine formation. Aldehyde reacts with ammonia to form an intermediate compound. Further dehydration, removal of water to produce imine. C double bond NH groups are imines. These imines are also acts as skips bases. Okay, so for this reaction, how to write the direct product? Very simple technique. Here RCH double bond O aldehyde. Aldehyde on treatment with ammonia, NH3 ammonia. Here removal of water, it gives RCH double bond NH. Very simple reaction. Okay, aldehyde molecule, ammonia, final product is imine. Here imine formation. Okay, this is the direct reaction. How to write the product immediately? Aldehyde plus ammonia, removal of water, we are getting imine. Okay, this is imine. Similarly, here one more reaction, either aldehydes or ketones, RC double bond O H aldehyde, or here also ketone, here aldehyde or ketone. Now this aldehyde or ketone reacts with aniline, C6H5NH2, aniline. Okay, what happened here? Removal of water, nucleophilic addition, removal of water, so gives rise to here RCH hydrogen or alkyl group, aldehyde or ketone, and a double bond here N and C6H5, C double bond N. Okay, so this is also called as skips base, imine or skips base. Aniline is also a nucleophile, okay, because of lone pair of electrons are present. It is also acts as nucleophile. Ammonia is also nucleophile. Aniline is also nucleophile. Reaction with NH2OH, hydroxylamine, NH2OH, hydroxylamine, yes, carbonyl compound, CC, carbonyl compound with hydroxylamine, NH2OH, what is the expected product? Here oxime formation. Okay, carbonyl compound reacts with hydroxyl amine NH2OH. This is called as hydroxyl amine. Okay, hydroxyl amine on treatment with carbonyl compounds, oxime formation takes place. For example, here aldehyde, RCH aldehyde, plus hydroxylamine NH2OH. Okay, what happened here? Nucleophilic addition, direct product formation is removal of water. Okay, oxygen from carbonyl carbon and two hydrogens from hydroxylamine, removal of water, RCH double bond NOH. This is called as aldoxime formation. Okay, aldoxime formation plus water, H2O. Why? Because it is a aldehyde with hydroxylamine, aldoxime formation, aldehyde with hydroxylamine. Similarly, ketone, RCOR, this is ketone plus hydroxylamine NH2OH gives rise to ketoxime formation, RCR double bond NOH plus water. This is ketoxime. If it is aldehyde, aldoxime formation, ketone, ketoxime formation. For example, if you take acetaldehyde, CH3CHO, acetaldehyde, plus hydroxylamine NH2OH. What is the expected product in this reaction? Removal of water between carbon and nitrogen, it gives CH3CH double bond NOH. This double bond NOH is called as oxime. It is acetaldehyde, therefore it is called as acetaldoxime. Okay, it is a acetaldoxime, acetaldehyde. Okay, acetaldehyde on treatment with hydroxylamine to produce acetaldoxime. Okay, if it is reacts with ammonia, imines formation takes place. Imine. If it is reacts with hydroxylamine NH2OH, oxymes formation takes place. If it is reacts with hydrazine, hydrazone formation takes place, hydrazones. If it is reacts with phenylhydrazine, NH2NHPH phenylhydrazine to produce phenylhydrazone formation. Okay, if it is reacts with 2,4-dinitrophenylhydrazine to produce 2,4-dinitrophenylhydrazine, hydrazones, phenyl hydrazones formation. Here semi-carbazide, it is reacts with semi-carbazide like NH2, NH, CO, NH2, semi-carbazide to produce semi-carbazone formation. These are the nucleophilic addition reactions. Okay, carbonyl compounds means aldehydes and ketones. Aldehydes and ketones are reacts with ammonia to form amines. Amines formation takes place. If they are reacts with hydroxyl amine, formation of oxanes. If they are reacts with hydrazine, hydrazones formation. If these are reacts with phenyl hydrazine, phenyl hydrazone formation. 2,4-dinitrophenylhydrazine, 2,4-dinitrophenylhydrazone formation. Semi-carbazide, semi-carbazone formation. Right, now one by one, here ammonia over hydroxyl amine over remaining hydrazine. Reaction with hydrazine. Okay, reaction with hydrazine. Reaction with hydrazine. Reaction with hydrazine. Yes, aldehyde, RCHO aldehyde reacts with hydrazine, NH2, hydrazine, removal of water to produce RCH double bond NH2. This is called as hydrazone formation. Aldehyde with hydrazine, aldehyde hydrazone formation. Here it is also ketone, RCR double bond O, NH2 ketone. Here same product is obtained. Here ketone hydrazone NH2 hydrazone formation. Okay, this is reaction with hydrazine. Next, reaction with phenyl hydrazine. Reaction with phenyl hydrazine. Reaction with phenyl hydrazine. Same, removal of water. Aldehyde on treatment with phenyl hydrazine, NH2, NH, here this is C6H5, removal of water, it gives RCH double bond NH C6H5. It is called as phenyl hydrazone. Okay, it is a phenyl hydrazone, phenyl hydrazone formation. If it is ketone, RCR double bond O, phenyl hydrazine, NH2, NH, C6H5, removal of water, RCR double bond nitrogen, here NH, C6H5. Both aldehydes and ketones are produces phenyl hydrazones. And another one is 2,4-dinitrophenylhydrazone. Reaction with 2,4-DNP, 2,4-dinitrophenylhydrazone. Reaction with 2,4-dinitrophenylhydrazine. Reaction with 2,4-dinitro 2,4-dinitro phenyl hydrazine. Okay, 2,4-dinitro phenyl hydrazine. 2,4-DNP, 2,4-dinitrophenyl hydrazine. Yes, aldehyde RCHO. This is aldehyde. On treatment with 2,4-dinitrophenyl hydrazine. This is 2,4-dinitrophenyl hydrazine. At second position nitro group, fourth position NO2 group. 2,4-dinitrophenyl hydrazine. Removal of water. Removal of water, as a result it gives RCH, okay, double bond NH C6H4 NO2 NO2. This is called as 2,4-dinitrophenyl hydrazine. 2,4 dinitro, 2,4-dinitro phenyl hydrazone. 2,4-dinitro phenyl hydrazone. Okay, this is the orange red color PPT. Aldehyde with 2,4-dinitro phenyl hydrazine to produce 2,4-dinitro phenyl hydrazone. It is 2,4-DNP. Either it may be aldehyde or ketone to produce phenyl hydrazone, 2,4-dinitrophenyl hydrazone. Yes. Then go for next one is reaction with semicarbazide. Reaction with semicarbazide. Yes, semicarbazide, aldehyde RCHO, aldehyde. On treatment with semicarbazide, NH2NHCO NH2, this is called as semicarbazide. A removal of water, it gives RCH double bond N and NHCO NH2. This is called as semicarbazone preparation. In this semicarbazide, NH2 NHCO NH2, this amino group is more basic. It is more basic than this. It is less basic amine, less basic. Because of the reason is, this amino group is directly binding with the electron withdrawing CO group, but here NH2 group is attached to the N. Therefore, it is more basic than terminal amino group, which is directly binding with the CO group. Okay, this is semicarbazone. Okay, all these are best example for nucleophilic addition reactions. Okay, amine ammonia reaction, imine formation, hydroxylamine, oxime formation, hydrazine, hydrazone formation, phenylhydrazine, phenylhydrazone formation, and 2,4-dinitrophenylhydrazine, 2,4-dinitrophenylhydrazone formation, semicarbazide, semicarbazone formation. These are the best example for nucleophilic addition reactions.